Assalamu alaikum, Shubh Sankar. There are two very disturbing news. I'm sorry to start this with the disturbing news, but is a very relevant for this workshop. It reveals that out of 28 countries in Asia Pacific countries, the second highest number of unemployed, educated unemployed youth are in Bangladesh. And between 2010 and 2017, the number of educated unemployed youth has doubled in Bangladesh. Where is this uneducated youth are coming from? That is, educated youth are coming from who are not getting employment. As you know, the large number of people, around 50 million people, who are in madrasa system, especially in Qaumi madrasa system, the largest number is coming from there. The second largest number is coming from general education, of course. And third largest number is coming from the trained TVET graduates. They are trained, but they are not getting employed. 20%, 30% people who are getting employed. Right? It is in this context NTBQF and BTEB seminal work assumes a great significance for this country. And all of your contribution to a strengthened NTBQF system makes so much of sense given this context. What is the point in getting training when I'm not getting employment? It adds to the frustration, it adds to the number of people who are aspiring youth, educated youth, who have so much of their lives to go ahead, but they are not looking inside. So this is where NTBQF brings value, because according to all the statistics, 80 to 90% people get job. We get a special request from other ministries. BMET, requested us, please start program with us. And in the recent sustainability workshop in October, they reported that all the people they had trained, they have gone abroad as migrant workers, and all of them have got a job in 4-star or 3-star. Okay. So this is the magic of NTBQF system. And BTEB has made a seminal contribution. ILO has invested, out of all the investment going in skill system building, I can say that ILO has made maximum investment in skill system building at BTEB. And the government has taken over this as their own project. So, we are very happy that out of 60 million investment which we have mobilized from different agencies, Canada, EU, most of it have gone into building a new system which is market driven, which is relevant to the market. I just give you some example of BTEB, especially in the last 3-4 years. What they have achieved. If you look at the figure of 2015, there were number of ISCs, before 2010, if you see, there were only 5 ISCs. In last 4-5 years, it has added to 12 now. There are 12 ISCs now. If you look at the number of occupations for which we have competency standards, in 2015, it was 51. Right now, it is more than 127, and it is getting added up. A STEP project, SIT project, all of them are now, joining the hands. Sudarko project, they are all coming and joining hands in creating more number of competency standards. The number of RTO, it was 38, and today it is 259. So the number has gone many, many times more. Certified trainer, certified assessors, you know, there were 353. Now it is, as you heard from two speakers, is more than 1150, around 1200, you know. NTPQF of graduate, there were 7,279 in 2015. Right now, it is more than 40,000. I'm just giving you some examples that in such a short period of time, you know, what BTEB has been able to achieve. You know, this is a very good example. why NTPQF gained more jobs than the traditional system? Because it is industries who are joining hands in developing curriculum, telling that what should be the competencies. They are joining hands in making a joint assessment for certification. So why should they not employ them? If they are setting the curriculum, I mean they are contributing to set the curriculum, if they are assessing them, then why should they not employ? Give me one reason. So the system is such where employment is, if not assured, then it is definitely, it has a much higher potential than the your regular system or traditional system. As somebody said, that what we have been teaching 25 years back, we are still teaching after 25 years, when the world has changed, the demands of the industry has changed, the competencies have changed, the technology has changed. You know, so how do we make our education system in general and technical system in particular more relevant to the industries to enhance these jobs? And it is there your contribution has been immense. And I must congratulate each one of you for joining hands in this skills reform, which has the maximum potential to give jobs to people. Thank you very much. I'm thankful to BTEB for inviting me to this conference.